You're watching In Your Interest, and time now to put the focus on JEE Mains for 2025. The National Testing Agency has approved a new format now. In a major update for engineering and architecture aspirants, the National Testing Agency, or NTA, has announced changes to the Joint Entrance Examination, or JEE, JEE Main 2025. The exam will now no longer feature optional questions in Section B, a change that will impact all three papers, Paper 1 for BE and BTech, Paper 2A for B Architecture, and Paper 2B for B Planning. The option questions were originally introduced to address challenges posed by COVID-19 pandemic, allowing students to choose 5 out of 10 questions. However, following the World Health Organization's declaration in May 2023 that the COVID-19 public health emergency had ended, the NTA has decided to return to the original exam format. The agency has assured candidates that details about the revised examination pattern will be provided in the JEE Main 2025 Information Bulletin. We have Mr. Keshav Karunakar now joining us to help us understand this better. Keshav, talk to us. What kind of an impact will this new format have on the students?
Good evening, Sai. Thanks for having me. So this is a good step. If you remember the neat fiasco that has happened of rank inflation, the rank inflation seen in IIT mains also, JEE mains also. So because of COVID, NTA tried to reduce the burden on the students. There are options given out of the 10 questions, you can select 5. Same problem is there with the NEET also. NEET also, you get the options to select questions. I'm assuming that this will be carried forward to NEET. It's a good step. Basically, there's no benefit in giving this type of choices in competitive exam, creating the rank inflation, and then have the students suffer for this reason. So I welcome this step. This is in the right direction.
This is a step in the right direction, Keshav. And you're also saying that the fact that like this step will now, the National Testing Agency will now look to expand this and make sure that this applies to other competitive exams, not just JEE.
Yes, at least for NEET, it should be applied to NEET, because the whole fiasco or hangama happened because of NEET exam last year, if you remember the exam that has happened. And there also you have physics, biology, chemistry, all the papers. You have options out of that you can select based on whatever you want to choose. So this will go off and this will hopefully reduce, and I'm confident it will reduce, because in the choices, people have different options to do it. So it's in the right direction, and in the IIT mains also, this is a good step done by the NTA.
And in that sense, it is the right time as well, because you know the COVID-19 pandemic, yes, has been declared as something that's over and done with. And considering the confusion that we had around NEET earlier in the year, it's important for greater standardization and examination procedures in this country, isn't it?
Yes, it is. It is indeed. You see this, the kind of hangama that happened with the NEET time, people lost faith in the system. Almost it was like people were saying that what type of question is that 61 people are getting 720 or 720. Same inflation was there in the IIT also, but it was not raised that high because of NEET exam, only one exam is there. IIT had two exams, a student appear in that to get double chance, but NEET you don't get second chance. So competitive exams where seats are less, there is no point in making question either easy or giving multiple choices, options of the selection. So it doesn't help. Board exams and other places, it's okay, because bulk of the people, the purpose is to pass them. But in competitive exam, it's not in the interest of the student's fraternity. And this is the right step taken by the NTA.
Right. And Keshav, one last thing. So for now, the paper 1 for BE and BTech, paper 2A for Bachelor of Architecture, and Paper 2B for Bachelor of Planning. These three, all three of the JEE are the ones that will be covered by this. So does that mean that students will have a tougher time preparing for it, considering the leeway that they got in the recent times?
No, it is not tougher time. If you see the people who qualify, they prepare for the toughest thing, right? It is only going to have that you will not have rank inflation. You will have really good talent qualifying this because it's a competency exam and it's a process of rejection. It's not a process of selection. So the results will have merit. Results will be honored by the students. So it is not going to be tough for the students who are going to qualify. Anyway, who is not qualifying, the exam has to be tough. Then only because number of seats are less. So you can't have easy exams in the process. And because they've done for BE planning, architect, everything, I'm assuming that they'll soon announce for the NEET as well.
So we'll leave it at that. Keshav Karunakar, thank you so much for taking time out to be with us here.
Thanks,
for this big story that we're tracking. And with that, we have completely run out of time here on this edition of In Your Interest. Thank you so much for watching. This is Krishna Kumar signing off.